I'm George Mariner Maul, Artistic Director of the Discovery Orchestra. And this is Holiday Meters Part 3, another addition to our series of Discovery Orchestra chats on the music listening process. At the Discovery Orchestra, we teach the listening skills that help people connect with classical music. If you have not watched Holiday Meters Parts 1 and 2, get caught up and watch them first. If you have watched Parts 1 and 2 of Holiday Meters, you already know that our first order of business is to detect the underlying beat or pulse in the music. So here's yet another musical example from George Frideric Handel's oratorio, Messiah. Find that underlying pulse. Have you found the pulse or beat? Once again, I'll tap along. Have you sensed that underlying beat? I hope you have. But let me just say it. Ba, 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 ba. Listen again. Now, is that pulse or beat organized in twos, threes, fours? Feel, sense with your body where there are slight stresses or accentuations. Is that beat organized one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, or perhaps one, two, three, one, two, three, or one, two, one, two, one, two? Listen this time for the meter. What do you think? And once again, if you're feeling that the beat is organized in twos or fours, I'll take either answer as correct because you are correctly sensing the duple or quadruple nature of this beat. It can be two or four. As it turns out, it is written in quadruple meter, in a four beats per measure configuration. Why it's so important to sense the meter in this movement is that, harking back to some of our other chats, Handel delivers a very effective rhythmic surprise to those of us who are giving this music our complete attention. In this movement, within the metric framework of four beats per measure, Handel has the chorus sing the words, "The Everlasting Father," in exactly that rhythm, two times. Here's an example of it. So we get that, the everlasting Father, two times like that. But the third time, well, you listen. The everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Yes, now it's the everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. The emotional impact of that one little rhythmic change is cosmic. And Handel takes off from there into what is the most emotionally intense music of this entire chorus. Listen for this one effective rhythmic surprise. A change from the everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace, to the everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, and be moved by it. Here's the entire chorus. And a Merry Christmas to everybody.
Come, Almighty God.